of these, the weary and the weak. And it would be a tragedy for me to turn away. All my needs you have supplied. When I was dead, you gave me life. How could I not give it away so freely? And I'll follow you into the homes of the broken. I'll follow you into the world. Poor and the needy, God, I'll follow you into the world. Use my hands, use my feet to make your kingdom come. To the corners of the earth until your work is done.
candidates come up here to the front. We're going to spend a minute of time in prayer this morning. Normally we would do our family prayer later on in the service, but we're going to do it with the early part of our service. So I'd like our four candidates that are getting baptized this morning to come on up to the front, up here, and I'm going to ask you to give a short little thought about. Jerry just gave me the look. She just rolled her eyes. You're going to do it?
Is that okay?
That's absolutely fine.
Yes.
It's good to be able to see our five candidates. Katie wasn't 100% certain, and now she said she's going to do it, so we're good. That's okay. But we want to be able to we want everybody to hear your own story, a little bit about what brought you to this moment in time. It can be as short as a sentence and as long as a paragraph. Not a book. There's no books. So it's what God has been leading them. And then we want to pray for them and ask God's blessing on them, not only for our service this morning, but God's blessing on them as they go forward from this day. So I'm going to slide off over to the side here, and Katie's going to be the first one because you're standing right here. Okay. You want to go first?
Sure.
Okay.
I was baptized as an adult 20 years ago, so I thought, well, I don't need to be baptized again. But then I was just thinking about it as I was hiding at back, having a cigarette, that I want a new relationship with Jesus again. Three times the charm, right? So I'm hoping that I can learn more self-love through this. Is that good? That's okay.
Then, Jerry. She's not 100% certain. She rolled her eyes at me really well as she walked. Okay. What brought you to this place?
After losses in my life, I was feeling lost myself, and it led me to your church.
Can't hear her.
Good. And I feel so at home. I have a new family, new friends, and I want to commit myself to Jesus, and this is the day.
Absolutely. Woo-hoo! Excellent. That's so good. Oh, I think you might have to step over here because I only have a limited amount of cord.
So throughout my life till now, I've known Jesus since I was little, but there's a difference between knowing someone and having a relationship with them. And I found myself a while ago that I wasn't living for him the way I wanted to be. So I started to live for him and
first
in all my relationships, and like now I'm here.
Yay.
That's what I wish I said.
I like to dedicate my life to my Lord, and you are all a bunch of beautiful people. Thank you.
The Lord gave us a choice that we could make in our lifetime, and it's difficult for some people, but you either are for God or Jesus, or you are against them. And I decided to change my life and be with Christ and give my life to him and honor him. Thank you.
Thank you. The best is, you guys can go back and sit down if you want. That's fine. But we are going to want to pray for you all, and that God will continue to bless you and give you the strength to live as you've said, as all of you have said, to live for Jesus here in this world, in this lifetime that we have now. So we're going to do that this morning. We want to really dedicate that this time. We're going to pray.
Can I change my mind?
Absolutely.
Yay! Yay!
I didn't come prepared to do this. It's all getting wet. I've known the Lord for quite a few years, but making this
commitment and this statement in front of my new family and this wonderful church and my wonderful Lord. I am just so thrilled. I wasn't going to do this, but the Lord said do it. So here I am.
And there's always room for more. Always room for more. That will be the invitation that we will give before we go down to the lake, is there's always room for more. Somebody to say, hey, I want to do this too. I want to go through this. So I want to pray now for each one of our candidates. We want to lift them up before God. We also, there's a few other things that we do want to pray about. We want to pray as well for, continue to pray for Dorothy Chase. I was thinking Dorothy might be here this morning, but she's felt that it's not able. So she is recovering from a blockage in her intestines, and that's, it's meant she's been doing a liquid diet. And she had a little bit of, she had permission to have a little bit of solid food last night, and she said it tasted like heaven. Is that right? So we're grateful for that, but we will continue to pray for Dorothy as she recovers from this. And we'll ask God's blessing on her. Anything else we can pray about this morning?
I have a Rue update. I saw Rue this week, and she was about 10 feet away from me, and she said, hey, Sherry, can you do this for me? And I went, wait, can you see me? And she said, yes, I can see all the expressions on your face. So her vision has returned. Her color has returned. So then I asked about baby Henry. And baby Henry, I guess there's different levels in the NICU, and he has been risen to a new level. He now weighs 4 pounds, 5 ounces. He has 3 milestones to come to be able to come home. He has to be at the 35-week mark, like if he was still, if she was still pregnant, has to meet the 35-week mark. He has to weigh 5 pounds, and he has to be able to eat on his own. So they're expecting that he's coming home in about 2 weeks. Oh. And on baby news, I've been given permission for a praise that we're going to become grandparents again in March.
Yes, Hannah's expecting her third one and her last. She said that, both of them said that very emphatically. This is it.
Is it twins or just one?
We've seen the ultrasound. There's only one. So let's come before God, shall we? Let's bring these things to Him in prayer. Father God, we're so grateful to You today. Grateful for all the things You do, but grateful for the way You work in our lives. And thank You for each one of our 6 candidates that are here today. Thank You for the work You have done in their lives, the way You have spoke gently to their souls, the way You have asked them to make this commitment. Thank You for the way You have worked. We are so grateful to see and to be a part of each one of their journeys and their stories. Thank You for that, Father. Specifically, we ask for hope. We ask for her as she, as a young woman, starting, not starting out in life, but continuing on in life, may this commitment she makes today keep solid. May she always find hope in You. May she always know Your presence in a special way as she journeys through high school and then later on into wherever You call her to be. May she always have that passion and love for You, her Savior. We pray also for Katie. We lift her up before You as she is uncertain, perhaps redoing it, not certain if it's the right thing. But there's one thing that is certain, is that You are working in Katie's life. And so we pray for Katie. We pray that You would continue to draw her closer to You, strengthen her as she continues to live for You and walk with You. May she feel Your presence in a very special way, and may today be a signal of change in her life, where she says, no more, I'm not going to, I'm now going to be walking for You. And Father, we thank You for Barb, and we thank You for how You have worked in her life, and how she is standing and saying, this is my relationship with Jesus. Thank You, Father, for what You've done in her life and in Ivan's life. Thank You for their presence at our church, and we're so grateful for them. And we pray, too, Father, that You would be with her as she makes this step forward. Father, we pray that You would guide her, that You would encourage her and strengthen her. Thank You for what You do. Father, we pray for Bea. We ask, Father, for Your touch in her life. We ask that you too, Father, as she has made that choice to say, yes, Lord, this is whom I want to follow. This is the dedication I am making, that you would continue to guide her, continue to encourage her and strengthen her. As she goes through these waters, may she feel the presence, your presence in a very special way around her. Thank you for her presence with us in our congregation. And Father, we thank you for Harriet today, and we pray for Harriet. She wasn't sure, she still may not be sure, but Father, you have spoken. And we pray for her, Father, as she makes this commitment. I know she's worried about the water. She's worried about going under. Father, calm her heart today. Calm her spirit today. Speak gently to her. Thank you, Father, for what you have done in Harriet, how you have brought her into our congregation, how you've given us a new family member to be a part of. And we're so grateful for that. So we pray that you be with her particularly today. And for Jerry, we're so grateful for her. Grateful for what has happened. Not for the losses and the struggles that she has faced, but grateful that you have been there through them all. That you have guided her. You have encouraged her and strengthened her. And she now is a commitment to you. We pray, Father, that as she goes through these waters today, as she comes up, remind her that she is a new person in Jesus. One whose heart has been renewed by the wonder of God's love. Thank you for that today, Father. Father, for each one of these candidates, we ask your blessing on them. Because today is just another day, but it's the start of a new commitment to what you want to see happen. Guide them all. Father, we want to pray for we want to pray very much for Dorothy. We thank you, Father, for her love and commitment to us as a congregation, for the work she has done tirelessly over many, many years. We pray that you would help restore and heal that body of hers. Give her back the strength that she needs. Thank you for looking after her and making this issue not as serious as it could be. Thank you for being part of it. And thank you too, Father, for what you are doing in Rue's life. And my prayer, Father, is that somehow, through this situation that she has been through, and through those around her, that she would be introduced to Jesus. That she would be able to say, yes, I learned about Jesus through the people that I talked with, the people that were there, like Sherry, who's been there and loved her and cared for her. Thank you for healing her, for restoring her vision, for bringing her little boy to a place where he's growing. Thank you for all of those things. And Father, now as we turn our thoughts towards your word in a few moments, open our hearts and minds to hear it. But we recognize, Father, that on this day, the evil one is still lurking around the edges. And he wants to see each one of our candidates, each one of us as we gather here today, discouraged, frustrated, angry. That's what he wants, and he's going to poke us. So Father, I pray that as we witness these events today, that we would be encouraged, that you, God, are not dead, you are alive and working, that you are making a difference in people's lives, in our own congregation, and within our community. Father, we trust you and believe our lives in your hands today. Thank you for our time of prayer. We ask it all in the name of Jesus, our Savior. Amen. Sherry, would you and Ben lead us one more time, please?
Our next song is "The Battle Belongs to the Lord."
Thank you.
I chose the music for this, which was about 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, probably not. It was back before we went on vacation. So early part of August, I chose that. I chose the songs. And I changed my mind when we got back from holidays last week about what I was going to speak on. And guess what I'm going to be speaking on? Joshua. And that's the song is about Joshua. And that reminded me about about our candidates, about each one of them, as we face some of the uphill battles in life. I want to read to you Joshua chapter 1, verses 1 through 9. And then I want to give you, share a few thoughts with you from this particular passage. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide, Moses, my servant is dead. Now then you and all these people get ready to cross the Jordan River into the land I'm about to give them to the Israelites. I will give you every place where you set your foot. As I promised Moses, your territory will extend from the desert to Lebanon, from the great river, the Euphrates, all the Hittite country, to the Mediterranean Sea in the west. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and courageous, because you will need these people to inherit the land I swore to their ancestors to give them. Be strong and courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. I love that passage. I love it. Because it speaks about the change that was taking place in Moses' life, or in Joshua's life. In our series that we've been doing, Faces of Faith, Joshua is not mentioned in Hebrews chapter 11, but he's hinted at a whole lot. He was instrumental at bringing the nation of Israel into the promised land that God had given. This is a promise that had gone back generations, hundreds of years, perhaps closer to 1,000 years. That promise was given to Abraham, that one day they would have the land. And there they were now, standing on the cusp, ready to cross the river and go into the land. But Moses was gone. Moses was dead. Moses was the identity of the people of Israel. He was the one who brought them out. He was the one that confronted Pharaoh. We saw that over the last number of weeks. But he's gone. He's dead. And here in Joshua chapter 1, we see Moses being spoken to by God himself. If we were to take a step back into the book just before this one, in Deuteronomy, we would see Moses speaking to Joshua just before he dies. And in those moments, Moses tells almost the exact same message to Joshua. And then later, after Joshua is gone, or Moses is gone, God reiterates this message to him. He says, you need to get yourself ready. You've got work to do. And now, some people may look at this and go, oh, this is dealing with people entering into leadership. And I agree, it's part of that. But I think there's far more to this passage than just those entering into leadership. Because for all of our candidates, as they get ready today to go into the water, as they walk this process, the reality is God is saying to you, get yourself ready. Be prepared. There's going to be challenges that are coming ahead. But listen to what God says to Joshua. No one will stand against you. God's message to Joshua is as clear as it is to all six of you today. Actually, it's as clear to all of us as we sit here, no matter what challenges we may face in our lives. No one will stand against you, because God has said more than once that when He is on our side, there is no one that can stand against us. There is no one that can battle against us. He says, I will be with you. He said that. I will be with you, Joshua, just as I was with Moses. The presence of God had already gone in powerful ways. If you look back in time, under Joshua, when Joshua was there, you see, Moses, we see Moses introduced at the beginning of the book of Exodus. But we see Joshua introduced in Exodus chapter 17. And in that time, from then, all the way through the wanderings in the desert, all the way, he saw the Red Sea, he saw the Mount Sinai, he saw the wanderings in the desert. All of those things Joshua saw. He walked with Moses through all of it. And God says, I am with you just as I was with Moses. And you know, the great thing about being able to pass, not pass on our faith, but being able to look back is recognizing that people have gone before us. They have lived their faith. They have walked their faith. And they have been victorious. Hope, I think of your great-grandfather. Your great-grandfather was fabulous. Speaking with him, he was a man of intense faith. But such a humble man. You walk in his footsteps. That's beautiful. You get that chance to walk in his footsteps. And that's the same way with all of us. We can point back to someone who has made a difference in our lives. God was with them as he is with us. There's one phrase that is repeated over and over again by the Lord to Joshua. He says, be strong and courageous. I wonder what Joshua might have felt as he stood there speaking with God. Maybe he was quaking in his sandals. I don't know. They spoke it three times. In verse 6, I get the idea when he says that in verse 6 is God is saying, listen, Josh, you're going to need it. Because these people are tough. Moses had a hard battle with them. They had not been out of the land of Egypt hardly any time at all before they're already turning their backs on God and on Moses and wanting to go back to Egypt where there are leeks and cucumbers and onions. They were not very faithful. So I wonder when God says to Joshua, be strong and courageous. He's going, you're going to need it. These people are tough. This group of people that I call my own, they're hurt. They've got a lot and they need to learn. And you're going to need strength and courage to lead them. You're going to need it. Then he says it again in verse 7. And I wonder when he says it again, be strong and courageous. He's saying, know where your strength comes from, Joshua. Know where your strength comes from, Jerry. Know where your strength comes from, Barb. Harriet, B, Hope, Katie. Know where your strength comes from. He says, obey. Obey the words that God had given Moses. Listen to them. It's not a blind obedience, but it's a choice to follow and to hear the heart of God. Because even in those Ten Commandments that we looked at last weekend, is the heart of God that God longs for us to follow him. It's obedience that knows that the heart of God who wrote them. So don't get off track. But he uses an expression that's interesting. He says, keep them always on your lips. Now, if you know me, and some of you may understand this, but Sherry and David definitely do, I talk to myself a lot. Thank you, Jerry. I'm glad I did that. And I talk to myself, and I sometimes will sit there and I'm muttering. The idea that God had when he talked to Moses about keeping the word of the Lord on his lips is exactly that. It's like muttering to yourself, reminding yourself of the things that God has done and how God has taught and how God has led, how God has worked. It's taking the word of God and always keeping it in the forefront of our minds, reminding ourselves of what God does and how he works. So it's okay to mutter, Jerry. It's okay. Because God asked Joshua to mutter to himself, meditate on those scriptures day and night. Make it an important part of our existence, of our lives. And then he ends up saying, do what it says. You see, knowledge is great, and we can spend our time trying to understand God's word deeply. But if we don't do what it says, then all that's done is occupied space in our cranium. But it really needs to make a difference in our actions, in our words, in the way we treat other people, how we love people. That's what God longs to see his word make a difference. Now the last time he talks about be strong and courageous is in verse 9. He says, I have commanded you. Haven't I commanded you? Haven't I talked to you? Be strong and courageous. And I'm wondering if at that point Joshua is looking and going, "Hi, God, you know what? Is there any way that I can back out of this? These people are hard. I don't know if I want this. Can I resign?" And God says, "No, you can't. You can't get out of this. This is what I've got for you. I have commanded you. I have given you marching orders." Maybe Joshua was overwhelmed by the and intimidated by the greatness of Moses, his predecessor, or perhaps the responsibility that lay ahead of him. But he says, be courageous. I'm with you. I have commanded you. The great thing about God is that when God asks us to do something, he always has our back. All the time. There's never a time when God is not there for us. Sometimes we may hesitate to see it. Sometimes we don't see how he's moving. But God is always there. Sometimes we say, I can't do this. I don't know if I can get into the water. I don't know if I can go down under the water. But God, you can do this. God's there with us. God is there when he asks us to share our faith with a friend or a neighbor. God is there. He's already been and already done this. God says basically, you can do it. You can do it. And I think not only do our candidates need to hear that, but I think we all need to hear that. There are times when we quake in our boots and we're not sure what God wants us to do. We're not sure how. God, you can't ask me to do that. He says, you can do this. I'm with you, always. You see, God knows that Joshua didn't know the future. God knew that Joshua didn't understand what was coming next. As they stood outside of Jericho, about two chapters later here in Joshua, in the book of Joshua, Joshua had no idea what was going to take place. God doesn't know what's going to happen tomorrow for you and your lives. But God does. You don't. But God does. He's got it. Hope, he doesn't know what your life looks like ahead of you. You're still young. But God knows what your life is, even though you don't. We may not know when our last breaths on this planet will be, but God does. And until that point, we continue. We continue to trust in him, and he will be our guide. Because he says, I will be with you wherever you go. That's a privilege. Now, I'm going to close our message off with a quick word of prayer, and then we're going to the band is going to lead one song, and it's time for us to go to the lake. So we're going to walk. Any of you can stand up and come along with me as you want, or with us, not just me, as we walk. We're going to walk just to the right of the stones here, and then this it slopes down nicely into the water over there. And we are going to do the baptism there. But before I do that, I'm going to say a word of prayer first, and I'm going to ask our candidates to come up here, and I'm going to ask them some questions that I would ask in the water. But the reality is that you won't hear it down there. I would invite you to move follow along. If you just want to stand up to the rocks here and watch across, that's great. If you want to come alongside over there so you're closer, that's great. But just you choose as you decide to do in terms of getting over there. If you want to just sit and watch, that's fine. So let me close our time with a word of prayer, our message time, and then I'm going to ask our candidates to come up, and I'm going to ask each one of them, one by one, some important questions. So let's pray. Father God, we're so grateful to you for what you've done. Grateful that you lead us and guide us as your people. Grateful that as you spoke with Moses, the Joshua, so many years ago, you still speak to us. Be strong and courageous. Because at times our souls melt. At times we fear those around us. We fear the people that say the wrong things. Be strong and courageous. Thank you that your presence is with us. Father, as we now proceed to baptism, guide our steps, literally over stones, but figuratively as we make that commitment to you. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, if I can have all the candidates come on up here. And I'm going to do a simple, I'm going to ask each one of you, so I'll just ask you to come on over here, one at a time. And I would ask this same statements from them if we were in the water. So it's the same thing, just here it allows us to hear it easier than it does out there. So I'm going to ask you to respond with a simple I do or it is. Hope, do you confess repentance towards God and to the possession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Is it, to the best of your knowledge, your earnest desire to follow Christ in death to self and to walk with him in newness of life?
It is.
And do you promise, in dependence upon the Word and the Spirit of God, to follow Jesus and to serve him forever in the fellowship and mission of his church?
I do.
Thank you. Katie. I'm asking the same questions.
Okay.
Katie, do you confess to repentance towards God and to the possession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Oh, yeah. Yes, I do. Oh, yeah.
Is it, to the best of your knowledge, your earnest desire to follow Jesus in death to self and to walk with him in newness of life?
Oh, yeah. I mean, yes, I do.
Do you promise, in dependence upon the Word and the Spirit of God, to follow Jesus, to serve him forever in the fellowship and mission of his church?
I do.
Thank you. Thank you for not rolling your eyes, Jerry. All right, Jerry. Do you confess to repentance towards God and to possession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
I do.
Is it, to the best of your knowledge, your earnest desire to follow Jesus in death to self and to walk with him in newness of life?
It is.
And do you promise, in dependence upon the Word and the Spirit of God, to follow Jesus and to serve him forever in the fellowship and mission of his church?
Yes, I do.
Thank you. My dear Harriet, do you confess to repentance towards God and to possession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
I do.
Is it, to the best of your knowledge, your earnest desire to follow Jesus in death to self and to walk with him in newness of life?
It is.
And do you promise, in dependence upon the Word and the Spirit of God, to follow Jesus and to serve him forever in the fellowship and mission of his church?
I do.
Amen. Barbara, do you confess to repentance towards God and to the possession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
I do.
Is it, to the best of your knowledge, your earnest desire to follow Jesus in death to self and to walk with him in newness of life?
It is.
And do you promise, in dependence upon the Word and the Spirit of God, to follow Jesus, to serve him forever in the fellowship and mission of his church?
I do.
Amen. Thank you. B. Do you confess to repentance towards God and to possession of faith in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Thank you.
And do you, or is it, to the best of your knowledge, your earnest desire to follow Christ in death to self and to walk with him in newness of life?
Yes.
And do you promise, in dependence upon the Word and the Spirit of God, to follow Jesus and to serve him forever in the fellowship and mission of his church? Amen. All right, I'm going to ask you folks if you want to get changed, or if you have to, I'm going to go get changed because I'm not ready to go in the water like this. And then we will make our way over, as the band leads in the next song, we'll make our way over to the beach area over there for our baptism service.
Our next song is Father, I Adore You.
By your previous statements and by the questions that you've asked, that you are ready to make this commitment.
I am okay.
Again.
Yes.
That's wonderful. So put your hands in front of you on top of your chest.
Okay.
Nope, together.
Okay.
All right. Because of your statement, because of your faith, I baptize you in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The statements that you have given previously today, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Ready?
Well, you'll know, you know Barb, because of your previous statements that you have made, because of your faith in Jesus, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Because of your obedience, because of your desire to follow Jesus in the water of baptism, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
We have one more song and then we eat.